Thanks for joining us. We're going to make some end table templates to make some unique legs. Let's get to it. If you've never done this before, you should stick around.
He's crazy. He's crazy.
Can I put that in there?
Yeah. Tell him get to work on the end tables, right? Get to work.
Okay. Yeah, well, welcome back. We're going to get to work on these end tables like the boss lady asked. And so we're going to drop some plans. We're going to drop some plans to make legs that are similar to these legs coming up here on my coffee table. Now, I have some MDF board that's going to be, it's quarter inch. I'm just getting all the dimensions, so I'm just not guessing or going willy-nilly at it. And so here's my basic plans. I'm going to throw this up on the screen here so you can follow along what we're doing. Now, this is pretty, it's not rocket science, but it is wood science. That's what it is. It's wood science. And I like to be really careful with all my measurements on this because I don't want to have to do it twice. So I'm going to take my time and measure out where we're at in space and time, like rocket science, but it's wood science. And so you're seeing the similarities here, I think, a little bit. So like my instructions say, I'm going to go 2 inches in on each side from my square, which is 17 and whatever that says on there. So I'm going to measure 2 inches across on each side. And by doing it this way, I should come out to a symmetrical shape. If you haven't done this before, hopefully it will make sense as we go along. I'm going to use this as a template, glue my wood together for the legs. And then I'm going to have one form, universal, or seamless, is the word I'm looking for, form for my legs. Now it's getting to the point around our household, to the point where I wake up in the morning and I hear from my beautiful wife, "Good morning, where's the end tables? Why haven't you started?" And it's not getting that bad, but the pressure's on, and this does take a while. And maybe after this video, as you watch through, you'll see that you'll have some empathy for me in my case and why it takes a while to get these things done. And like I've talked in previous videos, it's not always that simple. It's not like you just cut a piece of wood and glue it together and there it is. When you're creating beauty, it takes time. And, you know, if you like taking naps, it takes longer amounts of time. If you got other things to do, it takes even longer amounts of time. So it is not rocket science, it's wood science. So where are we here in our process? As you can see, I kind of moved to the calipers. I forget that I have this, and just a lot easier to set the measurement and know that's your compass in which you will guide you through measuring. Makes it a lot more easier. Is that a word? More easier? Most easiest? I don't know. I just live here. Now luckily, if you're paying attention, you might notice I go off the wrong line sometimes. But luckily, I do catch it, so please pay attention. So you don't mess this up. There would be nothing worse than to have a line that's an eighth and a bit, an inch off or something like that. So, here we go. Now this is getting to the point in the project where it's starting to get pretty exciting. And it is motivating because you're starting to see the shape of what you've come up with come into fruition eventually. And this is the point where it's actually more creative than, I don't know what the word I'm thinking of, but it's more creative. And that's the part of woodworking I really like. I have a vision, and to be able to make that come into being is very satisfying. So now, with that being said, there are some things that I haven't quite figured out. And one of the things is how I'm going to glue these things together. It is kind of a wedge shape, so I can't really stick the piece in between there. On my coffee table, which I've shown you pictures of, or look back if you haven't seen that, I basically used some dowels, and I have a cheap-ass jig set that really made it almost more difficult because it didn't quite make them flush as I would have liked. And so some of the things I thought about doing was insetting it maybe a little bit. I'm just not quite sure yet. But whatever I do, I hope it works. Now, this point's kind of funny, but it's basically the best and simplest way for that I've come up with is just search around your shop. It's like a little game. Like, I spy with my little eye circles. And then you just pick things that might match this curve that you would want. And the best thing I can come up with this is pipe tape. And it seemed to do the job. So I'm just going to rough this in. After I get all these lines drawn, I'm going to cut it out with a jigsaw, and then I'm going to fine-tune it with sandpaper. Sandpaper. I don't know why I said it like that. Here's the little curves. Also, there you go. You can kind of see the shape of it. I like it. I don't know what you think, but I like it. Now here I'm just kind of measuring the curves and figure that I don't need a 2-inch piece. I probably need a 4-inch piece or a 4.5-inch piece. And so I grabbed this thing to see what the angles actually look like. Because what I'm going to have to do at some point is that cross brace, I'm going to have to cut an angle on it. And the answer is 98.6. Now, angles kind of confuse me a little bit, but my understanding is 90 is straight up and down, and that's a little past 90, so my calculations are correct. I think it's 8.6 degrees that I need to cut on each side. So what is that, 16, 17.2, so degrees collectively. Collective. Now here I'm just kind of messing around. I'm thinking, let's double check it, and I'll just mark a line, put the board on the template, and that just didn't work. So now I'm making up a cut list, which is a good idea to do. See what size pieces I'm going to need, and what I came up with is 26 inches by basically, I just kind of going over, because what's going to happen here is I'm going to glue the wood together. That's going to make it up. I'm going to take this template, put it on top of the wood I've glued up, and then I'm going to form the wood to the template. So you can see why it's really important to get this template right, because it is basically going to be the final form that my legs are going to be. Now I need to make two sets of these. So, quick math, I need four, I don't know how to say this, yeah, four legs basically, four sets of legs. That's probably the proper English. Doing a little cleanup here. I'm going to do the old glue a straight edge to my board. And this is the poor man's track saw, basically. And it's just as effective. You just gotta have steadier hands. make a habit of making sure if you watch my previous episodes, I have tried to make a cut, and there's nothing worse than a battering going dead on you when then you're in the middle of a cut. So here I'm just making a quick test cut, and it's a good thing I did, because if you look carefully, I kind of wandered a little at the end. Let me check out my blade selection here. Brought to you by Diablo. This isn't a sponsorship, but if they want to sponsor me, go for it. So I found this little scroll saw. I think it's going to work just fine. It's a smaller, less wide bit, so I can go around those corners. And this is such a thin piece of wood, and it's soft, so don't need too much. See how it kind of varies there. I was looking underneath, and I was like, wow, I was pretty close there. So just a point of interest that I should be careful there. Now the surface on the jigsaw basically is an inch and a half. So whatever line I'm trying to achieve cutting, I'll just measure in an inch and a half. Set my straight edge, aka level, inch and a half off my line. Just make a couple marks across, and then there we go, on the count of three. Okay, there's no going back at this point. There we go. Doodaloo. So we're gonna kind of go through this. Gotta make sure it's set there. Now, I'm not a professional, and I'm just saying this off the cuff, and it is interesting to watch myself work, but it's pretty good, by the way. I like that. But it is good to kind of know your surroundings and know what's going to happen with the wood as you're cutting it and using power tools, and just be safe out there, kids. Just be safe. There we go. So there's a cut here, cut there, here a cut, there a cut, everywhere a cut, cut. I'm actually getting places. So I'm going, doing the inside legs, and eventually we'll get there. Oh my gosh. Oh boy, for a second there I thought I was just like gonna cut that off. Luckily I stopped. Now on the inside corners here, I'm basically gonna drill a hole. And in hindsight, well, actually I know why I did this. Why did I do this? I can't remember. Oh, so I can get the scroll saw in there and go straight across. I just cut those pieces. I probably could have just got around these corners with the jigsaw on its own after I did this, but you know, it's tit for tat, it got done. But looking at this, I just realized at this moment I probably could have gone around that corner, drew a straight line, and then it's probably just easier this way, to be honest with you. Though it's a good starting point. Here we go. Yum. Yum. I am really excited to get to this point. Things about woodworking I like is creating, building, having a finished product. Things I don't always like is sanding. I just don't like sanding and making mistakes like that. There's a little mark and it just slid. I don't know if I just didn't have it tight enough. I think that's the case. So I'll just fix it. Now, I live in Nebraska, and I don't know about you guys, but it was negative 35 degrees the other day with wind chill. Today, it's like 50 degrees outside. It's insane. It's like a 80 degree, 90 degree difference. Jeez. Anyways. So we're cutting across, and we're getting the corners here. Look at those detailed shots. So this little scroll saw worked wonders in these little corners, so it's pretty good. So I think this might be the last corner, and then we'll actually have it. I'm gonna bring it over to the tables there and see what they kind of look like. It's looking pretty good. I like it. I have some cross braces, which you'll see in the future. And right now it kind of looks like a electric pole to me. Looks like one of the big industrial power poles, but I like it. So we're just gonna clean up a little bit. Now it's time to cut the lumber so that we can glue it together. Put some of my tools away. I know, despite popular belief and looking at my garage, I do pick up from time to time. And I'm gonna pull out my cut saw, get the width cut on these. And it's funny watching this because it's relatively short video, but when I watch myself do this, it's fun to watch it in fast motion because everything takes a lot longer time. Now, things are gonna get frustrating. And so stay tuned for the frustration. I'm flipping the board to make sure that the flat machined edge from which I picked it up at the supplier, they planed or put a joining edge on one of the ends. So I make sure that's against the fence. Just double checking my cut list, basically how many board feet I need. So I'm going to cut these to the 26 inches, 52, and then another number. And then once I cut them lengthwise, I'm going to cut them widthwise to have the boards that I need. So yeah, there we're at 26. For some reason, this is kind of satisfying to me, using a square. I like it a lot. I also like donuts. I like pizza. So here's my cut saw. Puts a little shadow line, which I love. I like this. This is a really nice saw. Never regret buying this thing. So we're going, and I like to make small passes rather than just plunge it in. So I'm just going slowly, get through it. Looking good. Get ready to plunge through. Final cut here. And then boom. What the fuck? The power went out. Alright. So I turn it back on. It was just, went out again. So the blade got stuck in the wood. So, like a real man, I just powered it out. And, so we're getting ready to go. All right, now we're fucking A. Oh my God. Do you see that kickback? What the fuck? Now this happened like 3 or 4 times. It's getting to the point where I go inside, my wife's like, you know, that turns off the cable box. I'm like, well, yeah, and it also keeps you from cutting wood. Power is important. We both need power here. So I think it took me like 2 or 3 trips back and forth just to cut. What the f***? Now at this point, I'm pretty frustrated, as you can imagine. Jesus Christ. Now at this point, I'm You can kind of see my white shirt. I think I'm hiding from my wife because she can't watch TV. She's pissed at this point. Not really, but you know. So, I finally got through the three pieces. And I'm going to have to come up with a solution. Thinking of making a wind turbine. I don't know what I'm going to do. Put up a dam, generate power. But then I realized I got my car, which is a fully electric. And it's got a vehicle to load. And I've done this before. Go watch my first video. But I can't find my little adapter. And I'm looking for it. It's not there. And there it is. It's like a little Easter egg hunt. It's where I left it. The last place I would think to look where I left it. I just left it plugged in because I was plugging my vacuum in there. Now, this is a common problem in my garage. If you're running power tools, if you don't know, they draw a lot of power. And then if you're running a vacuum on top of that or another tool, it's unless you have extra service, it's bound to go out. So I got the green light from my car. I happened to buy this cord on a different trip. Just plug this puppy in, and I can't quote you on the exact power amount, but I want to say it's 1500 watts or something like that. 15 to 18. So, after a little doing, it's cold in the garage now. Maybe it's get towards the evening, so it's probably 40s, maybe reaching down to the 30s. Turn on Mr. Heater, which is a beautiful partnership. Okay, I'm a little frustrated, calming down, got a solution to my problem. Does anybody see that hole in my roof? Anyways, here we are. I got them cut, so I'm gonna put them through the table saw, not after I clean up a little dust. And so, I gotta say, it is nice having some tools that fold up and can be moved out of the way. And, toodaloo. There we go. We got power. Power. Again, using the joined edge row woods. Anyways, 4.5. That's my goal. It's getting warm in the garage, getting comfortable again. The trauma is behind us. So no more worries. Stuff started coming out of there. So I blew it out and then there's more than a little. There was a lot. Okay, so back at it. Here we go. I'm in my shorts and t-shirt in my garage, so it's that Mr. Heater really works. And then, son of a bitch, it stopped again. Now I'm kind of like, at this particular juncture in my life, I said, I'm going to try it one more time, and then I'm going to go eat a donut, like things that I know will make me happy. I'm a little frustrated. It literally was like 6 or 7 times the power stopped. So simple cuts. And to my delight, it just worked fine after that. I don't know what the dealio was, but it's kind of amazing if you ask me that you can plug your power tools into your car. Now, car has, I think that particular car has 88 kilowatts. So to put that in perspective, your home, average home is like 30 to 40 kilowatts a day. So you could run your house for probably for a couple days off my car. Cray cray. So here's my skydiving exercises. I don't know why I'm looking down for so long, but There we go. I'm sharing the air with the rest of the tools. And here we go. Now I'm gonna end the video here in just a little bit. Please stay tuned. There's a little more stuff to come. But that's for one table. And I'm gonna clean up here. I didn't realize till like 5 minutes later is that I gotta do that again for the other table. That's just for one side. So when I was trying to put that up, I was going the wrong way. Am I folding that up? So we get this folded up and we're good to go. There we go. Rock out with your socks and your shoes, as I always say. Just gonna unplug my car from my house. And I've learned a little. I'm gonna unlock my car to unlock this. Come on, come on. And I need your guys' help with something very important here. I'm going to show on the video where I'm putting it so I don't lose it again. So you guys are going to be like my wife and tell me where it is. I can't find it. So there we go. The garage door is symbolic of another chapter in this saga of making end tables. Mr. Heater's going to take a nap, turn off the gas, and call it a day. Thanks for joining us. Please like and subscribe, and we hope to see you next time. I really do appreciate you being here, so now we're going to do something very special and have a staring contest with my dog. She usually wins these things, so 3, 2, 1.